Poolesville High School is one of the oldest high schools in Montgomery County.
25.
We're unique now that we are the only whole school magnet to meet the needs of all our students.
These are students driven to succeed, who want to go further, who want to be challenged.
It takes a lot of intensive, like, critical thinking.
There is a component of writing and presenting and researching and developing solutions to problems from day one when they walk in the door.
It's not a competitive environment. People are competitive with themselves, not with each other.
Take measurements, take data, analyze that data, write up scientific papers.
It's really fun. I mean, we've gone on like a lot of field trips so far.
You can learn better to actually like be in the environment.
Everyone in the town knows each other, so it's a very nice family feeling that everyone's really close and connected to each other.
Hi, welcome to Poolesville.
The school has a very warm environment, and it's very welcoming and very open and encouraging for new students.
You really get to know everyone, and you become such great friends.
Yeah,
you have to be here to get
in. Connection with each other.
So we find that building relationships and building friendships is a key component to the success of what we offer at Poolesville.
With some really high-tech tools, rooms, and facilities.
The experience of learning in the program has just been phenomenal.
We deliver a program that is challenging and authentic and rigorous and tailored to a student's interests at every grade level. These programs are very engaging, very stimulating, and we really stress real-world products in the activities and the assignments and the challenges that we give the students.
The program itself is meant to be challenging both in math, science, and computer science, and we have done so for the children that have tested in and worked through the program with us.
My home high school would have been Gaithersburg High, and it is definitely much closer. However, I was really concerned about what would be the program, what would be its rigor, and the first thing that I thought was I want to be able to prove to these people that I can do it, and I wanted to take on that challenge.
The best match for us is a student that really enjoys, and not that the subjects come easy to them, but they enjoy the science, they enjoy the mathematics, they enjoy the challenge of problem solving.
Students start taking physics and calculus in ninth grade. And these students take 8 periods a day. They take an extra class because their program is so packed with necessary requirements.
We have our brand new science wing. It's 7 complete laboratories that have been set up for our advanced sciences and all science classes that are offered at Poolesville High School.
It makes you want to learn even more just because you're put in a situation where you know that you can succeed and achieve your goals.
Oh, that is great. We will need this.
What we're looking at now is the research and design class. Each team of students has to create, design, and build a safety product for the general population. Computer-controlled machines, you know, industrial drill presses, bandsaws, lathes, that will allow the student to fabricate a solution to a problem. And then they have to make a commercial, they have to do a presentation, they've had to do market research, and so we have them go through this entire process once again from the engineering standpoint.
When I went on college visits, some schools would be like, okay, so what have you been doing? Or they would explain something to me in their engineering department, and I would be like, oh, I already had that experience. I've used this before. And so they were like, wow, because they're teaching their students right now and they're in college.
The crown jewel of our program for some of our students will be to go out and do some independent research at some government or private facility and have a senior research project. They are creative, independent learners that can go out and work in the professional world and work with professionals and then come back and be able to talk about it.
At Poolesville High School, we have a humanities magnet program where we bring in very bright, talented kids from all over the upcounty area to delve deeper into the arts, into English, into philosophy, into the different aspects of the social sciences and social studies.
The Korean War.
We're not just teaching, for example, an AP model. We're teaching them models of argumentation. We're teaching them different strategies for writing. We're teaching them the critical thinking skills that go beyond just sort of giving back information in a classroom.
It's a highly creative program. Students are very involved in the media. They create films and podcasts and are very skillful with the current technology.
The goal is to have students become responsible global citizens willing to critically reflect upon history while at the same time plan for the future.
That's a popular project to do documentaries, and so we work in the Mac Lab with Final Cut Pro and iMovie, whatever we can get our hands on and understand really quick to do some really creative projects.
We ask that our students all take a media literacy class and a philosophy class, but then there are also opportunities for the students to take law, for them to take an art history class at the AP level. We like to introduce them to sort of a smattering of what the humanities are, and then encourage them to find their strand and go a little deeper.
During the course of study in the ninth grade curriculum about the 1920s, students attracted the attention of the Washington Post by holding a jazz cafe where students transformed VHS into a decade of long ago.
It's only been one quarter and I've learned so much. Like, my writing has improved, like, a ton.
Oh, and the blocking is awesome.
Yeah.
You know, having all three classes, because then you can just get in the zone.
The freshman and sophomore years, it's sort of like their first 2 years in college, where they get a nice broad background. In their junior and senior years, we want them to choose to look at digital or media art, we want them to look at visual or performing arts, or we want them to do a cultural and political studies thread.